Who foolishly hung and fostered it? If love so sweet, so simple. men who have never known true happiness.
Oh, but the truly happy always seem to have so much on their minds. Truly happy never seem quite well.
There is a transcendentality of delirium, an acute accentuation of the supremest ecstasy, which the earthy might mistake for indigestion. But it is not indigestion. It is aesthetic transfiguration. Enough babble. Come, let us away.
Oh, stay. I have news for you. The university football team, the 35th Dragoon Guards, have returned to campus. They're probably on their way to this very spot.
The 35th Dragoon Guards?
They're fleshy and full of habit.
We care nothing for the Dragoon Guards.
Oh. Bless me, you were all engaged to them a year ago.
A year ago?
Poor child. A year ago, they were all very well in our eyes. But since then, our tastes have been etherealized, our perceptions exalted. Come, let us lift up our voice to dear Reginald, lest we miss him before his next lecture.
Very.
We are all fond of toffee.
Yes, and toffee in moderation is a capital thing.
To live on toffee. Toffee for breakfast, toffee for dinner, toffee for tea. Tell me, suppose that you care for nothing but toffee and would be offended if anything but toffee were offered to you. How would you like it then?
Oh, I suppose under those circumstances, even toffee would become monotonous.
Yes. Now, for toffee, substitute flattery, adulation, and abject deference, carried in fact to such a pitch that I began to suspect the man was born at a 45 degree angle with a camera attached to the end of his arm. What is there to adulate in me? Am I particularly studious or witty or excruciatingly intelligent? I'm not particularly accomplished.
You're about as commonplace a lesbian as ever I saw.
Exactly. That is exactly, that describes me to a T. But of course they don't see that. So I applied to this second-rate team. As a female player in the Football Association, I thought I should be perpetually ridiculed, occasionally snubbed, perhaps even bullied. The thought was rapture, and here I am.
Yes, and here are those who we most dearly missed.
Oh. But who is the gentleman with the bow tie?
I don't know.
He seems popular.
He does seem popular.
Around the corner I can see each is kneeling kneeling on their knee.
Round the corner he can see, each is kneeling on their knee.
Now is not this ridiculous, now is not this preposterous, a follow-up with absurdity, ridiculous, preposterous, explain it if you can.
Oh,
it's not this ridiculous, and this one is preposterous, a follow-up with absurdity, explain it if you can.
Next to you and think of faint lilies. Wind shakes the innocent geranium and thoughts that whistle through my cranium hum their synthetic monotone. For what can ever now be final if it has been caught on vinyl by the fragrant gramophone? Time, like the needle in the groove, will not concede to let us choose the moment of mortality. The cosmos, a mere florid fable, turns us on its great turntable, listening to Morrissey. Yes, the truth is rather drastic. What else are our lives but plastic, waiting for the pin to catch? And when the destined end comes near, it is superfluous to fear it. It is but a scratch.
Oh, how purely frequent, how earnestly precious. It seems to me to be nonsense.
Nonsense, yes, perhaps, but oh, what precious nonsense.
This is all very well and good, but you seem to have forgotten that you are engaged to be wedded to us.
It can never be. You are not vintage, you are so mainstream. Lattes. Drink lattes, ere it is too late.
Red and yellow. Primary colours. Oh, queer eye!
Well, we didn't choose our uniforms, but I don't see how they can be improved upon.
No, you wouldn't.
Still, there is a silk, delicately patterned and hand-tied bow tie, surmounted atop a simple yet refined white shirt that hides untold secrets, and perhaps with a pair of braces that have not been practical since the 1910s, and oh, at least playing by the side would be hipster. Come, let's away.
This is an insult to our beloved uniform.
A uniform that has been as successful in the courts of Venus as on the football fields of Mars.
When
always wear it once. So say if my strings are well placed, on a uniform handsome and chaste. But the pair of potatoes, the top of your aesthetics are very much more to their taste. We're joined up and counted upon when I first put this uniform on.
Patience. Ah.
pleased with thee. The bitter-hearted one who finds all else hollow is pleased with thee. For you're not hollow, are you?
No thanks, I've eaten. But I beg your pardon, I interrupt you.
Is the poet's curse to be interrupted? The soul, yearning for solitude, labours under such things. Oh, I'm a wretched one. Oh, I am a cursed thing. Don't go.
Really, I'm very sorry.
Tell me, girl, do you ever yearn?
I yearn my living.
No. Do you know what it is to be part hungry, to long for the indefinable, yet be confronted daily with the multiplication table? To long for charities, yet find only plug holes? To wish for whirlwind, yet have to be content with the mere spinning of the fidget spinner. That is my curse. Oh, I am a wretched thing. Don't go.
Sir, if you please, I don't understand you. You confuse me.
Don't be frightened. It's only poetry.
Well, if that's poetry, I don't like poetry.
You don't? Can I trust? Patience, you don't like poetry? Well, truth be told, I don't like poetry. It's hollow, unsubstantial, and unsatisfactory. What's the use in yearning for Elysium fields where you can never get them and would only let them out on leases if you had them? Patience, I have long loved you. I am not as bilious as I am. If you like, I can wear a belt instead of braces. There is more jovial fun in me than the average eye would portray. You've never seen me frolicsome. Be a good girl. A very good girl. And one day you shall. If you're up for jocular fun, this is the shop for it.
Sir, I will speak plainly. In the matter of love, I am untaught. I have never loved but my grandfather, and I'm quite certain that under any circumstances I could possibly love you.
Oh, quite certain?
I'm quite sure of it. Quite sure. Quite.
Very well. Life is henceforth a blank. I don't care what happens to me. I only ask that you do not betray my confidence. Though you seem to despise me, I am very popular with the other hipster students.
I only ask that you leave me and never renew the subject.
Very well. But before I go, if you please. Away! I shall depart into this black Akeldama of sorrow, where the dust of an earthly today is the earth of a dusty tomorrow. A little thing of my own. I call it heart phone. I shall not post it. Farewell, patience. Patience! Farewell.
What on earth does it all mean? Why does he love me? And why does he expect me to love him? It confuses me.
Patience, whatever is the matter?
Angela, tell me two things. Firstly, why on earth is this love upsetting everybody? And secondly, how is it to be distinguished from insanity?
Poor, blind child. Oh, Eros, forgive her. Love is, of all passions, the most essential. It is the embodiment of purity, the abstraction of refinement. It is the one unselfish emotion in this whirlpool of grasping greed.
Oh dear.
Well, why are you crying?
To think I've lived my whole life without experiencing this ennobling, unselfish passion. What a wicked girl I must be. For it is unselfish, isn't it?
Absolutely. Love that is tainted with selfishness is no love. Oh, try to love. It really isn't all that difficult if you put your whole mind to it.
I'll set about it at once. I won't go to bed until I'm head over ears in love with somebody.
Noble girl. Is it possible that you've never loved any man?
Oh, one?
Who?
My grandfather.
Grandfathers don't count.
Then there's nobody. At least, nobody. Not since I was a baby. But that doesn't count, I suppose.
I don't know. Tell me about it.
Child of beauty, heaven, mother says, and what to say?
child, I seem to be all that a little child should be.
I am much taller. taller and stouter than I was.
And have you been pruned?
Yes, patient.
I am very beautiful.
I'm sure it doesn't make you unhappy.
Yes, patience. Gifted as I am with a beauty that has not its rival upon this earth, I am nonetheless completely and utterly miserable.
Why?
My child love for you has never faded. Imagine then the horror of my destiny when you learn that it is my hideous fate to be loved at first sight by every person I come across.
Why do you make yourself so picturesque? Why not disguise yourself, disfigure yourself, anything to escape this persecution?
No, patience, that cannot be. These gifts, irksome as they are to me, were given to me for the enjoyment and delectation of others. I am a trustee for beauty, and I must see my trust faithfully discharged.
Are you too a poet?
Yes, patience, I am. I am the apostle of simplicity. I am known as Archina, the all right, for I'm infallible.
Archina, is it possible you condescend to love such a girl as I?
Yes, patience, is it not strange? I have loved you with a San Franciscan fetishizing frenzy for full 15 years.
Oh, marvellous. I should have been deaf to the voice of love. I seem now to know what love is. It has been revealed to me. It is Archina Grosvenor.
Yes, patience, it is.
We will live and die together.
We shall never, ever part.
I swear it.
We both swear it.
But, oh, horror.
Why, what's the matter?
Why, you are perfection, a source of endless ecstasy to all who know you.
I know I am. What of it?
Then there can be nothing unselfish in loving you.
Oh, merciful powers, I had not thought of that.
We have eyes and features on which all people love to linger. It would be unpardonable.
Surely it would. Oh, my fatal beauty, again you interpose between me and my happiness.
Thoughtless, beautiful than you are.
Oh, if only I were, but candor compels me to admit that I am not.
Our duty is clear. We must part. And forever.
Farewell, patience.
Farewell, Archina. But stay.
Yes.
Although I may not love you for your affection, there is nothing to prevent you from loving me. I am plain, homely, unattractive.
Why, that's true.
Well, for such a girl as I must be unselfish.
Unselfishness itself.
How to marry you would very selfish be.
Thank you.
Prize! Exactly so.
But
Reginald, and sworn allegiance to his rival. And all forsooth, because he hath glanced with passing favour on a puling milkmaid. Fools, of that fancy he will soon weary. And then I, who alone remain faithful to him, shall reap my reward. But do not dally too long, Reginald, for my fashions are ripe, Reginald, and already I am out of vogue. Let us secure me ere I too am gone.
Be too smart for him in the coming night.
old, old tale. How rapturously these hipsters love me, and how hopelessly. Oh, patience, patience, with my heart so full of love for you, how can there be anything left to them but unvalued pity? I shall die of hopeless love for thee, as they shall die of hopeless love for me.
Oh, miss, will it please you read it to us?
Read it to you? Why, certainly. What shall I read you?
One of your own poems.
One of my own? Better not. They will not cure you of your love.
Mr. Bumpon used to read us a poem of his own every day.
And to do him justice, he read them extremely well.
Oh, did he now?
Well, who am I to deny you what Mr. Bumthorn does not? I am a trustee. All right. This is a decollete. A very simple thing. A daisy. A babe could understand it. In order to appreciate it, you need think of nothing at all.
Well, let us think of nothing at all.
Peaceful Portia was as good as gold. She always did as she was told. She never spoke when her mouth was full, or caught bluebottles their wings to pull, or spilt plum jam on her nice new frock, or let white mice in the 8-day clock, or vivisected her latest doll, or fostered a passion for alcohol. And when she grew up, she came out as a lesbian, and on primetime TV was romanced by Ellen. There was not one word in that decollete that was calculated to put the blush of shame upon the cheek of modesty, was there?
Not one. It was the purity itself.
Here's another. Teasing Tom was a very bad boy. A great big squirt was his favourite toy. He put live shrimps in his father's boots and sewn up the sleeves of his Sunday suits. He punched his poor little sisters' heads, and cayenne peppered their four-post beds. He plastered their hair with cobbler's wax, and dropped hot pennies down their backs. The consequence was, he was lost to all, and shamed last week as a Twitter troll.
Oh, mark you, how grandly the damning catalogue of crime strode on till retribution, like a poisoned hawk, came sweeping down upon the wrongdoer. Oh, it was terrible.
Oh, Archie, you are a true poet. You touch our hearts and they go out to you.
This is simply cloying. I'm terribly sorry, but you have been following me about ever since Monday. And today is Saturday. I should like the usual half holiday.
Oh, no, Archie, I do not send this from you.
Oh, poor, poor people. It is best I speak plainly. I know that you all love me. But I can never love you, for my heart goes out to another. Remember the fable of the Magnus in the Churn?
But we don't know the fable of the Magnus in the Churn,
don't you? Well, then I shall sing it for you.
Magnetic, peripatetic, love she lived to learn. My going down and my goods
person I come across. A curse on my fatal beauty, for I am sick of conquests.
Argina!
The patience!
I've escaped difficulty from my Reginald. I wanted to see you so that I might ask you if you still love me as fondly as ever.
Loved you? Why?
Hold! And hand me your ice cream! If you are a lady, pray remember that I am another's.
But you do love me, don't you? Madly, passionately, despairingly.
That's right. I could never be yours, but that's right.
And you love this bumthorn, do you?
The wholehearted ecstasy that withers and scorches and burns and stings. It is my duty.
Admirable girl. But you are not happy?
Happy? I am miserable beyond description.
That's right. You can never be mine, but that's right.
Go now, I see the Reginald approaching. Farewell, Archina. I cannot tell you how happy this made me to know that you still love me.
Oh, if only I dare!
This language towards one who's promised to another? Oh, think of me sometimes, Archina. My heart is breaking. He is unkind to me. And you would be so loving.
Loving!
Advance one step, and as I am a good and pure woman, I scream! Farewell, Archina. Stop there. Advance at your peril. Once more to you.
In a tall full dream,
one and one I walk on.
Crying, eh? What are you crying about?
I was just thinking about how dearly I love you.
Love me? Bah!
Love him? Bah! This crushes me. What's the matter, Reginald? If you have any sorrows, tell them to me so that I might share them with you. It is my duty.
With whom were you talking with just now?
With Archina.
With Archina? This is too much!
A great deal too much!
You be quiet.
Should again! I think she's the noblest, purest, and most perfect being I've ever met. But I don't love her. It's true she's devotedly attached to me, but I don't love her. Whenever she grows affectionate, I scream. It is my duty.
I dare say!
So do I dare say. Well, how could I love her and love you as well? You can't love two people at once.
Oh, can't you?
What? I only wish I could.
I don't believe you know what love is.
Yes, I do. There was a happy time when I didn't. Bitter experience has taught me.
Love is a plaintive song. Sung by a suffering maid, telling a tale of wrong, telling of hope betrayed, tilted with changing night, slowly with hastened, blind to his every moment, and
gone wrong for me since that smug-faced idiot got there. Before that, I was admired, dare I say, loved.
Too mild, adored.
Do let her personally look wise. The hipster damosels all used to follow me. Now they only follow her.
Not all. I am still faithful to you.
Yes, and some hipster damosel you are.
No, not hipster. Hippie? Oh, cheer up. I am still faithful to you, and I swear I will never leave you.
Thank you. I know what it is. It's her cursed mildness. They find me too highly spiced, and no doubt I am highly spiced.
Not for my taste.
Yes, but I am for theirs. But no matter. I'll beat this woman on her own grounds. If they want insipidity, then they shall have it.
They shall. And I will help you.
You will? Well, there's a good deal of good in you after all, Jane.
So go to him and say to her with compliment ironical.
Good day to you, and that's what I should say.
Your style is much too sanctified, your cut is too canonical.
So about you, and that's what I should say.
I was the bold ideal of a morbid young aesthetical. To death my inspiration was regarded as heretical. Until you put me on with your facility and vertical.
Sing boom to you, boom boom to you, and that's what I should say. Sing boom to you, boom boom to you, and that's what I should say.
Sing day to you, good day to you, sing well to you, boom boom to you, sing boom to you, and that's what I should say.
Yes. In that case of precedent and single, I'm so in time. I shall have to be she will have to be contented with a heart for sympathy. In the case of precedental single, she was able to have, she will have to be contented with a heart for sympathy. She will have to be contented with a heart for sympathy. She will have to be contented with a heart for
on those features which all others may gaze at, on their goodwill. Ah, I am a very Narcissus.
It's no use, I cannot live without attention. Yes, okay. Ever since Grosvenor got here, insipidity has been at a premium. Ah, there she is.
Take a look at this. Is it not graceful?
Why, yes, no. That's very graceful.
No, not that. This.
Bah! I'm in no mood for trifling.
Why? What's amiss?
Ever since you got here, you've entirely monopolised the attentions of the hipster students. I do not like it, miss.
My dear sir, I cannot possibly help it. Their attentions are a very plague upon my life. My dear Mr. Bunthorne, with your personal disadvantages, you cannot possibly conceive of the horror of my situation, of being madly loved at first sight by every person I meet.
Miss, until you came here, I was adored.
Exactly that. Until I came here, that's my grievance. I cut everybody out. If you could only suggest some means whereby, consistently with my duty to society, I could escape these unwanted attentions, I would be eternally grateful.
I will do so at once. However popular it may be with the world at large, your personal appearance is highly objectionable to me.
It is? Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you! Thank you! How can I express my gratitude?
By making complete change at once. Henceforth, you must be entirely commonplace. You will cover your shaven hair and have an off-centre parting. That's right! An off-centre parting! In your speech, you must be entirely matter of fact. In all things, mainstream.
That's impossible.
But where? When I'm thwarted, I'm very terrible.
I don't care. I am a woman with a mission, and that mission must be fulfilled.
I don't think you quite understand the consequences of thwarting me.
I don't care what they are.
Well, suppose, I won't say that I will do it, but suppose I were, for instance, to delete your Instagram account.
You would dare!
No, no, it would be an extreme measure. Still!
You couldn't possibly do such a thing. Mr. Bunthorne, you wouldn't. You couldn't. Oh, reflect, Mr. Bunthorne. You had a mother once.
Never.
Then you had an aunt? Oh, I see that you did. By the memory of that dear aunt, I beg you to pause and you consider this last, most fearful experience. Reflect, Mr. Bunthorne. Reflect.
I must not allow myself to be unmanned. Repent, or by the tap of a nephew's finger.
Halt! Are you quite certain that you're going to do this, then?
Quite certain.
And nothing could possibly get you to change your mind?
Nothing.
Very well, then. I yield.
You do?
Yes. Cheerfully. I have long since looked for some pretext to make just such a change as you suggest. Here is that pretext. I cannot help it. I do it. On compulsion.
Oh, fantastic. Victory.
I triumph.
When I go out the door, a dam has heard to score. For sign of burning and clinging, yet it would follow me as before. A shout with culture taste, distinguished gentle haste, and hide a diddle rank as an idiot, I pronounce it chase. A most intense young man, a soulful like a man, the social poetical supernatural out of the way a man.
See me if you will, an everyday young girl, a commonplace type with a hair curly pipe and a small Charles manual. Methinks some urban hooks, more fun than mine.
Maltese young man, a black and white young man. Francesca Rimini vapors a chimney, je ne sais quoi, young man.
A makeup and selfies young girl, a maid in Chelsea young girl, an easily available, highly predictable oyster card young girl.
A parent-seen young man, a vegan fanatic young man, an organic grocery only shop locally, man's name young man.
A KFC young girl, a fry money young girl, political apathy, vagueness, tragedy, take a break young girl. Conceive me if you will, a very day young girl, a social romantical, super aesthetic, a last my way young girl. Conceive me if you will, a very day young girl, a not romantical, super aesthetic, a last my way young girl.
It's all right. I have committed my last act of ill nature, and henceforth, I'm a changed character.
Yep. Reginald, dancing! What on earth is the matter with you?
Patience, I must apologise. Hitherto, I've been moody, fitful, in temperament, and selfish in my disposition.
Indeed you have.
Well, all that has changed. I have modelled myself on Miss Grove. From henceforth, I am mildly cheerful. I shall still be aesthetic, of course, but my aestheticism will be of the most pastoral kind.
Is this all true?
Perfectly true. Observe how amiable I am.
How long can this last?
With occasional breaks for rest and refreshment. As long as I do.
Oh, Reginald, I'm so happy! I cannot express the joy I feel at this change. It will no longer be a duty to love you, but a pleasure, a rapture, an ecstasy.
My darling!
Oh, horror!
What?
Is it quite certain that you have absolutely reformed? You're henceforth a perfect being, utterly free from defect of any kind?
Quite certain. I have sworn it.
Then I can never be yours.
Why not?
Love to be pure must be absolutely unselfish. And there can be nothing unselfish in loving so perfect a being as you have now become.
Never mind. I'll relax. I'll be as I was. Interrupted.
Crushed again!
I will have to be contented with a truly morning life.
He will have to be contented with a truly morning life. In the case of precedent and single, he will live and die. He will have to be contented with a truly morning life.
Thank you.